you, I don't want you to have sex with me this way, and then still you force yourself to her the way you want. What is that called?
You know, there was you write out a contract
in Islam. What is that called?
Yeah,
well,
yeah, when you get married, you know that, right? The woman actually agrees to it. You know that, right? You haven't got a clue what you're talking about. You're just
so woman is agreeing,
yeah,
that
she's agreeing.
Husband can force herself to him. Sorry, husband can force himself to her, however and whenever she wants.
What?
That doesn't make sense.
That doesn't make any sense.
Woman is agreeing with the Quranic verse. Husband can force himself to her. I'm gonna deal only with you, and the, okay, let's have a proper conversation.
So you hide the tafsir there in your social media.
Do you follow the old system?
See? This so, will explain so the verses properly. You get the context.
I'm gonna give the context, no worries.
This is your own context.
I'm gonna give you the context.
And if I want to get to tafsir again, or shall
so I just press there, scroll down, and
yeah, go ahead. Sorry, madam.
So, Sura 2, 223. Sorry, can you come a little bit this way? My stuff is here.
You're wasting time.
Your wives.
He doesn't want to listen.
Your wives are a place of cultivation. This is my translation. For you. So you come to your place of cultivation however you wish and put forth for yourself and fear Allah and know that you will meet him and give him good tidings to the believers. So that is the verse, and I'm gonna tell you when this verse is revealed, okay? And that your tafsir is going to confirm that as well. I am giving you from Abu Dawud, which is written much, much earlier from Ibn Kathir. I am sure as an Arabic speaker Muslim, you already knew that. So I read it again. Abu Dawud 21:59. Please follow it from the Arabic. If the translation is wrong, step in, okay? Yeah. Check it Arabic, Abu Dawud 21:59. Okay, ready? So, Ibn Abbas said, Ibn Umar misunderstood the Quranic verse. So come to your tilt however you will. That's the Surah 2, 223, okay? May Allah forgive him. The fact is that this claim of the Ansar, who were adulteries, lived in the company of the Jews, who were the people of the book. So there are a group of people who live in the company of the people.
What about the Jews? You didn't mention the Jews.
No, it says here, people of the book. Lived in the company of the Jews, who were the people of the book, okay? They, the Ansar, accepted their superiority over themselves in respect of knowledge, and they follow most of their actions, okay? So these pagans are learning lots of things from Jewish people so far. The people of the book used to have intercourse with their woman on one side alone. For example, lying on their backs. This was the most concealed form, in the parentheses, it's the vagina of woman. The clan of the Ansar adopted this practice from them. But this tribe of the Quraysh used to uncover their woman intensely and seek pleasure with them from in front and behind and lying them on their backs. When the muhajirin, the immigrants, came to Medina, a married woman of the Ansar. He began to do the same kind of action with her, okay? But she disliked it. She doesn't like the way man is having sex with her, okay? And said to him, we were approached on one side, lying on the back.
This is the Jewish lady.
No, this is the... So, there is a woman who is who lived in the Jewish community from
she's
the Ansar. No, she's not
Ansar.
A Jewish. Yeah.
And she was married.
She married, okay?
One of the Muslim,
yeah. Okay? So, we were approached one side on the back, do it so. Otherwise, keep away from me. This matter of their spread widely. And it reached the Apostle of Allah. So, man wants, woman wants man to have sex with her, only lying on her back. Okay? Man doesn't want that. That's good. Now you are reading in Arabic, so you can check it. You've got the source, remember? So, Allah, the Exalted, sent down the Quranic verse. So, Muhammad now heard how people are having sex with those women. Suddenly, Allah sends the Quranic revelation of Surah 223. Okay? Revelation is this. Your wives are a tilt to you. So, come to your tilt however you will. From in front, from behind, or lying on their back. This is the verse. Man in the place of delivery of the child, which means vagina. So that's Sunan Dawud 21:59.
Are you recording? Look, you're just trying to make.
No, I'm just finishing that.
No, hold on. Dawud
21:59. That is the background of the verse. Okay, read it. Can you read it?
Yeah, can you read it?
This one is wrong.
Which tafsir is this?
Yeah, this is the tafsir
of which?
Of the surah that
no.
You told me.
Ibn Kathir, Ibn Abbas, which tafsir? Jalalayan? Which one?
Here.
Tafsir of which?
It doesn't say here which tafsir.
So you don't even know whose tafsir is this? No, there are lots of options for the tafsir, I'm asking.
I read the Quran, but the brother was here.
Okay. Can I hold it?
Yes.
So the tafsir you are showing me, if you realize you have sin, sorry, so go to your tilt as you will. The Jew refrained from intercourse with their wives in the position of facing away from them, believing that a cross-eyed child would be born out of the resulting pregnancy. Muslims are told that it is right and safe for them to approach their wives in any manner they like, subject to the absolute prohibition mentioned above in 222. That confirms my point. You can enter your wife, you can have sex with your wife however you want. No. It talks about, remember, that's Jewish
where it doesn't, sir, Jewish were
practicing certain ways of sex. I already gave you the descriptions, and they're outrageous for me as a Christian to repeat it again. You can read them again. So, Jewish people were having sex in different ways. Suddenly, when they start marrying with the Quraysh people wants to have sex with the Ansar people who lived with Jews, and they learn lots of things from Jews. They don't want to have sex that way. What the verse says is, it's here. Sorry, you moved on. Sorry. So, they approach their wives in any manner they like, subject to the absolute mentioned in Surah 202. Above said, good forward, good tidings to the believers. Do good and send. That's moving to the next verse. Yeah. So it's here. Muslims are told that it is right and safe for them to approach their wives in any way they want. That's my point. Are you married?
Yes, I'm married.
So, when your wife tells you she doesn't want to have a sex with you the way you want her, there are the options here. Lying on her back, lying in the front, all those options are here. I'm not going to go through them. Your book tells you, you can have...
No, you're taking things out of concept.
I just read the context for you.
This verse was basically revealed at that time for a certain community of the society who are the Jews. You see?
But this verse is not revealed to the Jews. This verse revealed to the Muslims. Because look, it says, Meta reached the apostle of Allah. So Allah sent down the Quranic verse to the Muslims. That verse was not sent to the Jews. Jews says their own book. This is verse sent to the Muslims.
Okay, watch out. I think it's very clear, madam. No, it doesn't have nothing to do with the rape. Yeah, it's just trying to.
So you think it is not rape when your wife tells you she doesn't want to have sex with you in a way that you want her?
No, obviously I wouldn't approach.
I'm just asking a very simple question. Do you think it is not rape when your wife tells you she doesn't want to have sex with you on her back or on her face, whatever options are on the hadith?
No.
That's not rape.
It should be done by agreement. No. The intercourse between one man and a woman should be done amicably, nicely, with the agreement between both parties, even if they are in one entity. But the man shouldn't force. But I don't think here the Quran says that the man should force or rape. It doesn't. It's just trying to make it exaggerating.
Do you mind your name?
Hafif.
It seems to me, sir, that your moral standards are much better than Allah and Muhammad. Because in the Quran, Allah says, go to your tilts. Go to your tilts. Let me read it again. Your wives are tilt to you. Come to your tilt however you will. So you say, husband and wife need to be in an agreement regarding the sexual intercourse, but Allah says, come to your tilt however you will. Allah disagrees with you. And then I already read from the Ibn Dawud, Muhammad disagrees with you.
You are here, you're making video because you are programmed.
No, I make videos, yeah.
That's good, but you are programmed.
I'm asking you questions.
You say what you want to say, and you don't hear to others what you want to say.
I heard what you are saying. Because of that, I am telling you, Allah doesn't give that right to Muslims, but you are giving that right to Muslims.
Look, can I tell you something? Look, the thing is, look, it's natural instant, a natural relationship should be between a man and a woman. But God clearly says if they have their period, they can't basically approach them.
Sorry, I'm just looking for my Bible. I'm going to read something for you, just a moment. Daniel, don't steal my Bible. So I agree with you.
Yeah.
When sex takes place between man and woman, and Bible teaches that must be forever, I marry with someone, and then I know I'm going to die with that person. In that marriage...
Not really. If you marry someone...
I'm telling you the Christian's perspective. I know Islamic perspective is different.
Yeah. So you mean in Christianity, if you marry someone, you have to...
You become one flesh, and that goes forever until one of you die.
But it
happens or not. That's what my scripture teaches.
Yeah.
So, I agree with you. In the marriage, there is a duty husband has towards wife, wife has towards husband. And in a sense, I would say, yes, your moral standards are much higher than Allah and Muhammad. Let me finish. Because Allah says, come to your tilt however you will. It's not about the woman.
No.
Woman has nothing to say on that.
No.
I'm going to read it something for you.
Give the Bible. We're talking about the Quran at the moment.
Okay, I'm going to tell you what is the Christian perspective. Because I want you to hear what is the Christian perspective.
Clear the misunderstanding about the Quran. Because if you bring
there is, the Bible, that's not a misunderstanding.
It is misunderstanding, to be honest.
Okay, let's ask. She's a woman. Okay?
Yeah.
If your husband tells you he wants to have sex with you in the front and and then you say no to him.
No.
And if he wants to do that, if he wants to do that, is that rape or not?
Can we just stop for a minute? Is this the level of degrading detail
you're making an act here? It does.
So, Abu Dawud 21:59. If your husband tells you he wants to have sex with you in a certain way, and then you say no, and then Allah sent the divine revelation and then said, come to your till however you will, is that against your will?
That is totally against my will.
That's rape. Would you say that's rape?
Question the sexual intercourse thing in Islam. What happens if one person says no?
We looked at the Sura 223 and then we saw Allah gives permission to rape in marriage, and then we looked at the background of that Sura, that ayah in Abu Dawud 21:59, where women don't want to have sex the way Muslim wants.
Disgusting.
Suddenly Allah steps in and then Allah says, your wives are tilt to you. So come to your tilt however you will. Praise God that I am not a Muslim.
Amen.
And let's pray that all those Muslims give up this false and really, really disgusting and dirty ideology of Islam.
So degrading. So degrading for women. So degrading for wives. That the husband can just do what he likes. She has no say. She has no say.
Sorry, I passed my boundaries and I read all the description, but read the Arabic version of Abu Dawud 21:59. You will come across with lots of descriptions which is very ugly. So give up this false ideology and come to Lord Jesus Christ. What Christian scripture teaches, which brother didn't want to hear, husband must love his wife the way Christ loved the church. Christ loved the church, he gave up his life for the church. Husband needs to love the wife like that. Woman needs to respect and submit to her husbands in everything in the Lord. That's all Christian scripture teaches. Comparing that with Islam, we come to the conclusion Islam is ugly and false religion.
Talking about the intercourse, more natural position between a man and a woman.
Yeah, and then says on the back or on the front.
Where the seed,
Daniel,
where the seed comes from? You know, that's why they explain it. I mean, the metaphor example given in the Quran. Yeah.
In the Quran, it's a metaphor. Go to your tilts. However,
what
you will.
About? What
in the
saying?
Background, in the background, it is just simply saying. In the background, it is simply saying, enter your wife. However, whenever you will. It doesn't say have an agreement with one another, as you told me. All the heavenly beings will come and curse.
What if she's tired?
I already read the background of the verse. No, if she says that, all the heavenly beings will come and curse her.
It's proving that you don't
know. You should never stand in such a
thing. Sir, I already read the background of it. Your tafsir confirms that. Can I have your phone? Yes, it is talking about sexual intercourse.
If you come from the back, a child will come along, and the Muslims it says that's safe for you, go for it. That's what you're talking about.
What chapter is it? Tell us what chapter it is.
It doesn't say anything here about what if the woman has a headache, what if the woman's been looking after the kids all day, what if she's been at work all day and just doesn't feel like it, what if she's been and got a queasy tummy, what if she just doesn't want to. According to this verse,
he doesn't know what he's talking about.
Analogy doesn't work.
Whether or not she feels like it at all. And then the Hadith says,
analyze
what you don't know.
What if she's curse her in the morning? How horrible is Allah? How degrading of women is Allah? How thoughtless is Allah?
If you
illegal.
How can you analyze
a man?
How can you analyze something you have no
idea? Mohammed, do you know what chapter it is?
So here's the bottom line.
No, I already. I wouldn't carry on with it.
I'm gonna retake the Qadir for you, which will discredit
me. I really have an agenda.
My agenda is that speaker's corner is for you to give up that false religion Islam, and for you to rest, for you to allow those girls and your wives to be rescued by Lord Jesus Christ. I'm not saying Allah is a monster, I'm just saying he's false God. False God, what? False God,
the
very, very...
The verse is totally far away from what you said.
No, sir, I read... If today you discredit your hadith, I've got nothing to say to you.
I've got the hadith here.
Maybe you should... No, sir, no, you didn't bring me hadith. Where was your hadith? You did not bring me hadith. You did not bring me the hadith. Don't practice taqiyah. Hadith and tafsir is very, very different. I don't know about taqiyah, and then we saw you practice. So,
I heard you earlier.
I'm just going to... I'm already going to finish this conversation.
No, hold on. She's talking, she's throwing words that she doesn't know. Taqiyya, it's the political terminology that was used 100 years after the death of Muhammad by the Umayyin.
Can you prove
it? You mentioned earlier that Muhammad was preaching Taqiyya.
Okay, prove it.
This is absolutely...
Prove it, then.
No sense.
Prove it.
No, it's in the...
What you're saying?
No, it's not in the Quran. This is here. We're talking politics now.
It is in the Quran.
She's talking politics because she's mentioning the Taqiyya. No. She's mentioning...
Talks about Taqiyya. Tafsir ibn Kathir or Surah 328 say?
Don't let them control the conversation.
Uh-huh. You don't know that, do you? You don't know that one, do you?
Every week.
Trust me,
look. It's just a brother Christian that he just became Muslim. So every day we're having Muslim.
Let me just say something. I would love to take the opportunity and say thank you to you for not allowing me to read Surah 222 is tafsir, which is ugly and makes me throw up. You go and read it at home. 222 to 223. So, Ibn Kathir 223 confirms what Abu Dawud says regarding the background of the hadith.
Come back.
And it is very clear. Give up this false ideology of Islam. Get rescued by Lord Jesus Christ. Otherwise, it will be all right for you day after day to be get raped by your husband whenever they want to use you as their tilt. Ugly and disgusting. Come to Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. God bless.